I want to praise it for you, praise it for me. Praise it for the people that need to be saved, your family members that need to be saved. Praise God and give God some praise in advance. Hallelujah. Glory be to you, God. Jane, let's go ahead on and do this song, and we're going to go ahead on and get going. What a praise thing. Y'all might well come on up here. Y'all should have been praising God when you were coming up here. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Start that song, Jane. Start that song. Hallelujah. We bless you, God. We praise you, Father. We magnify you, Lord. We lift you up in this place. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We magnify you, Lord God. Oh, bless you, God.
Blessed assurance.
Come on, sing.
Jesus is mine.
Oh, what a foretaste.
Oh, what a foretaste.
Glory divine.
Glory divine.
As of salvation.
Heirs of salvation.
Purchase of God.
Purchase of God.
Born of his spirit.
Born of his spirit.
And washed in his blood.
Washed in his blood.
My little boy said, this is my song.
This is my story.
Says, this is my song.
This is my song. Raising my Savior.
All day. Blessed
assurance,
all is at rest,
all is at rest.
I am my Savior,
I am delight. Lord, happy and blessed.
Watching and waiting,
watching and waiting.
Looking above,
looking above.
Filled with God's goodness,
filled with God's
lost in his love. Everybody lift your voice and say, praising my Savior.
Praising my Savior. All day long.
Praising salvation.
Trials and valleys.
All that rest.
Hiding my faith.
We're happy and blessed.
Happy and blessed.
We watching and waiting. Looking above.
Looking above.
Filled with God's goodness.
Filled with God's
oh, hallelujah.
Day.
And we lost in his love. Everybody lift your voice and say, this
is my song.
This is my song.
Praise
my Savior. Bless you, Lord. We pray. Well, give him a praise then. Hallelujah. We worship you, God. We magnify you, Lord. We lift you up in this place. We thank you, God. We praise your holy name. Hallelujah. Right now, I give honor to my Bishop Sylvester Banks Sr., lovely wife, Mother Annie. Thank God to put your hand for them. Come on. We can do better than that. We can do better than that. Put your hands together for them. Put your hand together for my pastor, Robert L. Banks Jr., lovely wife, Sister Banks, all the ministers, all the mothers, the national mothers, everybody, Bible Church of God, our sisters and brothers. I'm born to, we thank God for each and every one of you. We love each and every one of you. We thank you for coming and being a part of this great service for our pastor. We love each and every one of you. Everybody, all our visitors, if you're not a part of Bible Church of God, you are welcome in this place. We love you. We're going to go through a word of prayer. Come on, D.
Actually, everyone stand. Come on, let's give yourselves a hand clap. Yeah. Hallelujah. God been good to you today. Yeah. Amen. That's what we come out here to praise our Savior all day long. Amen. Amen. For his goodness. Hallelujah. How he have kept us, provided for us. How he have made ways, doors that he have opened and closed. Hallelujah. We got a reason to praise him. Amen. For life, health, and strength. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bow your heads in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we come before you this evening thanking you for your grace and your mercy. Father, thanking you for the love that you have shared with us throughout this blessed day. Father, we give you the glory and all the praises, Lord, as we humble ourselves before you this evening, Lord. We just want to say thank you. Thank you for the love that you have given us, Lord, towards one another. Thank you, Father, for the word that you have shared with us on this morning, Lord, that it had broke down some barricades, Lord, some walls, Lord. Hallelujah, that it encouraged us to go forward. But Father, we are here to celebrate and honor the man and woman of God this evening, Lord. Our Bishop Robert L. Banks Jr. and our First Lady, Sister Karen Banks, and the family, Lord. We just thank you for this opportunity that we can come together in unity, Lord. Hallelujah, that we may edify one another. We thank you for our chief. Hallelujah, Bishop Sylvester Banks Sr., our lovely Mother Fanny, Lord. We just give you glory for the Bible Church of God appointed to Beach, Florida. We ask that you have your way and let your way be had throughout this entire service, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Yeah, let's do one song. We're going to get out of the way. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. See our bishop is here and Mother Church. Clap your hand, give God a praise. Amen. Thank God for you coming. We're going to do one song, then we're going to turn the service right into the hands of our mother church. And then we're going to do what we call do. How y'all doing, all right? I just seen y'all last week. You better be doing good. Very good. Looking good. God's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Amen. 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 Well, let's do one song. We're going to do one song, and then we're going to turn the service over to the hands of our mother church. And what I want to do, I like to talk prophetically, so I'm gonna do this song right here. Go ahead and tell your neighbor, hey neighbor, it's already done. Come on, do it again. Tell them, say it's already done. Amen. When you believe in God for something, you got to keep speaking it prophetically. Can you shout amen? Amen. Last day says, God, I pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy.
Amen.
Speak to the dry bones. Speak to them dead situations.
Amen.
What you gonna tell them is already done. You might want to get up because it's already done. Amen?
Amen.
Go ahead, let's do that. Amen. He said, clap the hand right there. Come on. Let's do it.
Holding fast to the promise
of what God,
to what God has spoken to me.
Promise me.
He promised me.
I believe.
If I believe.
Can't move
mountains. I can't move mountains.
Put them in the sea.
Into the sea.
And don't you know?
I believe what he said when he said it.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm holding fast to the promise.
word is already settled in heaven.
My word has been settled in heaven.
All you gotta do is call those things to be.
Now we must call those things to be.
Call it.
Thy kingdom come.
Will be done.
Thy will be done.
And like it is in heaven.
It is in heaven.
All those shall
be. And earth shall be.
And don't you know.
I believe what he said.
One time, it's done today. It's done cause I say I believe that it's already done. His promises and his word I've read, I believe that it's already done. You say
it's done. Come on, look around and get somebody and say, it's already done. I put it in the atmosphere, it is already done. My son is blessed, my daughter is blessed, my house is blessed. Come on, tell him it's already done. God bless you today, amen. Do something in this mic, Dick. I'm screaming up here. All right, it's already done, isn't it? Hey, believers, we got to learn how to talk prophetically. Death and life is in the power. Yeah, you gotta talk prophetically. If God said it, that means it's coming to pass. So if God said it, then they ain't never got to stop talking. Can you shout amen? Go ahead and turn to some neighbor. Say, I'm blessed. In the city, in the field, I'm blessed. Going in, going out, I'm blessed. My house is blessed. My bank account is blessed. My life is blessed. I'm healthy. I'm well. Everything about me is blessed. Come on, give him a praise. Hallelujah.
If God says you blessed, that means you are blessed. Can you shout amen? Clap your hand now. Thank y'all for coming so much. And I turn this service into the hands of Deacon Remus Johnson. It's on. Come on, say praise the Lord, everybody. Oh, glory. Y'all all right out there? God good, isn't it? Oh, you're so blessed. Praise God. You ought to give God the glory. The man of God has spoke everything that exists in your life. So that makes a good example to give God the praise. That's right. Every praise belongs to who? Every word of worship belongs to who? Praise God. Hallelujah. Boy, y'all scared to say hallelujah. Something wrong. Anybody tell y'all go eat all that food, don't even come right back to church to give God some praise. And that's right. That's all right. We're going to shout anyway. Praise God. Choir, will you please come at this time? Bible Church of God, Mass Choir. Give us a... We're going to praise God since God already blessed us with a word. Amen. Come on up. Y'all come on up. Give us a couple of selections. Praise God. Worship and praise. Let's give them a hand. They come. bless the Lord. Come on, let's worship Jesus. Hallelujah. I need you, Jesus. Each and every hour, I need Jesus. Come on, worship Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. We bless your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. We need you, God. Hallelujah. Bless your name. We give glory to Jesus, who is our life. We thank God for our bishop, Bishop Rob, and his wife, Carol. God bless you all. Thank God for Okeechobee. Give Okeechobee a hand. Hallelujah. Thank God for a bishop. Sylvester, let's give him and Mother Banks. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, do you have an insurance? I know you got insurance, but do you have an assurance? Jesus give out assurance. Allstate sell insurance. And you know, sometimes they don't stick firm to their word. But one thing about Jesus, you can depend on the assurance that he give you. Hallelujah.
Mine, oh, mine.
you here.
Talking about insurance. We got some insurance free policies. They ain't paid off yet. But assurance, heaven is your home, amen. You're saved right now. Not going to be saved, but you're assured that you're saved right now. The Lord shall call you assured that heaven is your home, amen. Insurance, you get insurance just in case. You get insured just because, amen. Because you know there's something better, amen. Let's get a Lord a great round of applause for the choir. And praise team today, praise man. Another day that the Lord has made, another year. Lord has kept the man and woman of God. Let's give our honorees, Bishop Robert and Sister Karen, another great round of applause for another year of service. God's humble servants, amen, carrying on the mandate that God has given them to do, amen. So we honor them for the tremendous work they're doing up here in Martin and Okeechobee counties. So you're doing a well-earned, received appreciation day. Amen? Amen. It's not giving somebody that didn't earn it, amen. They earned, amen? Amen. So we honor God again for this great occasion, amen. And not going along the time, we honor God for all God's men. Praise God for General Bishop. Praise God and his wife. Let's give him a great round of applause, if you will. All our great elders of this gospel, praise God. All our elders for them, praise God, and Pastor Jackson and Sister Jackson, we thank God for all our elders. Give them a great round of applause, great ministers, and all our deacons, all our evangelists, prophetesses, and all them other good S's. Thank God for you, amen, for all our ministers of the gospel, all our deacons, deaconesses. We honor you for the presence of God. I honor God for Sister Mary Banks. I got to be put a handle on. There's a lot of Sister Banks and Sister Mary, amen. Mama not here, so I guess she could be Sister Mary by herself today. She said she first. I said, I guess so. Amen. Amen. I honor God again for all our great choir. Let's give our choir Deacon Waters them another great round of applause. They sung so well at the convention on last week. How about that woman convention? Let's give her convention a great round of applause. Amen. Extreme makeover. Amen. 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 Thinking about the message Bishop preaching this morning about let them go. Word of God gets so far to preaching over and over and over again. People don't want to hear it. God said, let them go. I got this. Leave them alone. Say, I got it. Let it go. I got this. No, leave alone. Because you're going to go up there. You're going to uproot some of the wheat with the tares. So let me handle it. When I come in, I'm going to know what the right one divide. Amen. You done told them. You done did your job. You tell them what the word of God say. They reject. Say, no, they don't want to hear it, but the scripture said, shake the dust off your feet and go on down the road, amen. Amen. Stand to your feet, amen. We're getting forth to bring our presiding bishop another year, amen. Amen. Boy, I see you back there, Q. All right there, Mr. 49ers there. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Boy. Rewinding, I watching Anquan last year's Super Bowl again last night. I make sure I get that part. Highlight tape over and over again, amen. That first touchdown in the Superdome, amen. Amen. I honor God. God bless Tim and his family, praise God, and got him in a favorable position, amen. So we honor God for him and his faithfulness to this ministry, amen. Amen. Cute. That like a surprise. That's what you do, amen. I don't know why that was surprised. That's what you do, amen. Amen. Without further ado, we're going to introduce the psalm and present to others. General Chairman of Bible Church of God Incorporated, our presiding bishop, General Chairman, the Honorable Bishop Sylvester Banks, senior to the congregation. Let me see Bishop Banks by saying, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise God, amen.
God bless you. May you see it. Let's give the Lord a hand clap. Praise him. Thank you. Oh, God is good, isn't he? Oh, my God. How quick, how fast these years go by. Especially when you get my age. So, such a blessing, amen, to be alive in a great, exciting times. Be back to Okeechobee Indian Town. Give them a great big round of applause. Praise the Lord. We are so thankful for our overseer, amen, Bishop Robert Banks, Jr., Sister Carolyn. God bless you. God bless you for the splendid works that you're doing here in the county. It's such a blessing to have a church here. Praise it. Much needed. Praise the Lord. Isn't it a blessing? I mean, right on the highway, when people pass by, they can't hide, they get a big old sign. Praise the Lord. Plenty of property to expand. Amen. I know God got greater things right here in this spot. Amen. God gonna do greater things. If you should tarry, we are looking forward to it. Amen. Praise the Lord. We thankful. We're grateful for protocol. Clap your hand. Amen. For everyone, it's my wife and family. God bless you. God bless you. Here for the men of God and the woman of God who are worthy of these services, the flowers that we're going to restore upon them today. Amen. We thank God for Brother Boland. We've been praying for you. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Amen. So glad to be in your midst again. God bless you. God bless you. And have a heaven smile upon you. Keep on running. Praise the praise the Lord. God bless you. Bless your family. That God will ever keep your, amen, focus upon him. Knowing that it is the Lord. He's a good God, isn't he? Amen. He's a good God. He's a good God. And you have a good man of God and woman of God, one here who we can brag and boast on. Amen. Such a blessing. Such a blessing. Praise the Lord. Amen. The people wonder how you're doing in Okeechobee. I said, man, they're doing great. They are growing, growing, growing. Praise the Lord. It's blessing tremendous. Today we just came out of, clap your hand for the women's conference. Praise the Lord. Our national mother did a good job. Oh, glory. I was talking about them sisters more. Boy, they preach a long sermon. They preach longer than we do. I said, them sisters got some words in them. But boy, they get up there, I'll tell you, and talk about us. Goodness. Praise the Lord. Amen. But take out whatever watch. God bless you. So we know that you've been in service. We thank God, amen, for you. We came here today and you're already giving God the praises. So we're just going to leave some scripture verses with you, just some thoughts from the word of God today, if the Lord should say so. amen, give you something to meditate on and to study on. So turn with me swiftly to 2 Peter, first verse. Oh, no, I want the first verse, I want the first chapter. Praise him. Amen. Yeah, I know I had a little lengthy this morning, but I cut it short. I wasn't so short. I wasn't too long this morning. Was it? No. They was out of church by 1 o'clock. Or didn't I do good? Amen. Not too long. Not too long. Glory. That was all right. I don't want to. All right, let us note chapter 1, 2 Peter, let us note verse 5. And besides this, give all diligence to add to your faith virtue, and to virtue, knowledge, to knowledge, temperance, to temperance, patience, and to patience, godliness, and to godliness, brotherly kindness, to brotherly kindness, charity. For if these things be in you and abound, they make you that you shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But he that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar off, and has forgotten that he was purged from his old sins. Amen? So what a blessing. The scripture, he's telling us to do some adding, right? Praise the Lord. You do some add, not take from, but add to it. Praise the Lord. Amen. So I faith sometime and need some power. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Need some extra power. But then brother said, it's already done. Amen. That was a little faith and great faith. Yeah? Huh? Didn't Jesus speak about somebody had greater faith? Huh? Praise the Lord. Amen. So it is a blessing. So now we're going to turn from here. We're going to another Philippians. Hey, we ain't going to dwell there. Let's go to Philippians 4. Everybody say add. All right. Okay, you did a lot of that in school, didn't you? Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. And let us note chapter 4. Chapter 4. Amen. So let us note verse 8. Finally, brethren, whatsoever thing are true, whatsoever thing are honest, whatsoever thing are just, whatsoever thing are pure, whatsoever thing are lovely, whatsoever thing are good report, if there be any, that I word again, virtue, and if there be any what? Praise. Do what? Think on these things. I believe you have about 8 there to think and to meditate upon. Amen. It's just such a blessing. So when you're thinking up on these things, amen. You can add. Amen. Praise the Lord. You can add. All right. So now we're gonna go to another place. I'm just giving us a little lesson for you to meditate upon. We'll be out your way in a little bit. Praise the Lord. Think on these things. You know, a lot of people think on a lot of things. Amen. The word of God said, as a man what? So is he. Huh? All right, so if you think on things that is positive, you'll be able to speak positive. Out of the heart, abundant the mouth of what? Speak. So what are you thinking? All right, you're thinking, amen. If you let it go into your heart, then you'll talk it. Praise him. Amen. Believe in your heart. Amen. And confession with the what? mouth, then it's what? Made unto what? Salvation. Yes, man. You got to believe it in your heart, then you got to talk about it. Who knew there's life and death in where? All right, so you got to speak it. We're coming here tonight. Amen. Tonight, the pastor was saying, was singing a song, is what? It's already done. How you coming out? All right, if it's already done, you're coming out with your what? All right, you ain't got to come out crying if it's already done. All right, if it's already done, a victory, people who got victory, what they do? Amen. Come out waving. Come out with your hands up. You come out happy. Praise the Lord, somebody. Glory to God. So it's already done. But if you're to get it done, you got to think positive. Praise the Lord. You got to think on what the scripture said. Amen? Praise the Lord. You got the writer said, I meditate. How long? Day and night. I meditate upon what? The word of God. The word I hid in my heart that I what? Won't sin against thee while because I'm thinking upon it. Amen. I'm meditating upon it day and night. So if I meditate upon it, I must be got it in my mind. I must be got it in my heart. So if I got it in my heart, I got it in my mind, I'm going to speak it. Then if I speak positive, then it's going to be made unto what? Salvation. That word completely delivered. So I'm going to get deliverance, amen, from the word of God. All right, so let's go to Revelation. Revelation 3, almost there. Praise him. Just some lesson. Work on the mind, you see. All right, Revelation 3. Revelation 3. All right, we're going to note verse 1. And unto the angel of the church in Sardis write, these things says he that has the seven spirits of God and the seven stars. I know thy work, that thy has a name, that thy liveth and are dead. Verse 2. Be watchful and strengthen the things which remain that are what? Ready to die. For I have not found thy works perfect before God. Amen. Strengthen, strengthen the things which that remain you the things that you have in possession. Amen. The things that you have in possession, he said, be alert. Be watchful. Because the scripture said, therefore we ought to give the most earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we shall let them. All right, so we don't want it to slip. So don't want it to be to slip. So we got to be watchful for that which is in our possession. Because the adversary desired to steal it. John 10:10 said, the thief come. But what? Steal, kill, and what? To destroy. Amen. To destroy. To destroy. My people's destroyed because of the lack of what? Knowledge. You are destroyed because of the lack of knowledge. That's why you got to do some adding. That's why you got to do some thinking. And that's why you got to be alert. You got to be watchful, huh? And strengthen that which you have in your possession that are ready to die. Think in your life right now. Take an inventory of your life right where you're sitting. And examine yourself and see what in your life, in your possession, that need to be strengthened. Need to be strengthened. Praise the Lord. Oh, God. Need to be strengthened. joy? Is it peace? Is it long-suffering? If it's temperance, if it's faith, if it's meekness, if it's gentleness, and some more. You do the examining, amen. If you are weak in any of these areas of that fruit, the scripture admonished you to add, to think on them, and what? Strengthen them. The things that are ready to what? Some of them things in our life, some of them virtues in our life, they're just smoking. They ain't there. The blaze them, the fire done going in the left smoking. Praise the Lord. You ain't never strike your last match trying to put up a fire. You didn't have a fire. Amen. And that thing, that fire won't blaze, and you get out on your knees and you go to blowing. Praise the Lord, trying to get a blaze. You don't have no match. That's your last match. Praise the Lord. And you don't put the fire to it, and the thing is, it won't blaze up, and you're just smoking. You get down there, and you go to blowing. Praise the Lord. So that thing that you need nurture. Praise the Lord. Amen. If it's love, huh? If it's joy, it's something the scriptures speak a lot about joy. Huh? My God, you can draw water out of the well of salvation with joy. The joy of the Lord. The joy we like to sing, we like to preach, we like to say, the joy of the Lord is my strength. But sometime things happen in our life and we don't be too joyful. Come on now, come on. Somebody probably sitting here today, something done happened in your life and you ain't too joyful. And I know the word of God is talking to you. He's telling you to strengthen it. Get that joy back. Everything that the devil do. You like to say that word. Taking it back. I want it what? All back. Huh? You're going to zigzag and get it all back. David said, Lord, must I go after my stuff? The enemy have taken my wife, they have taken my good, they have taken everything. David said, Lord, should I go after my stuff? God said, go and get it. I'm going to give it all back to you. So he's a God that's ready to restore. Somebody say, he restored my what? Soul. He restored God. We serving a God that restore things. If you have, amen, left things, have lost things. The scriptures speak of the church in Ephesus, because thou has left thy first love. Left thy first love. Amen. Left. Amen. When you leave something, you ought to know where to go back and find it. Praise the Lord, somebody. You ought to know how to go back and find it. But you lost it. Sometime you're in trouble. But if you leave it there, amen, you ought to rethink. I have to do that a whole lot of rethinking while the age I'm in now. So when I want to backtrack something, I done put something down and I don't want to know where that. Then I started thinking, Trace, where have you been, Banks? Where have you been? You've been in the bathroom. You've been in the room. So trace that thing. It got to be somewhere where you done been. So I got to trace where I've been. And when most of the time when I trace where I've been, I found that object. Praise the Lord, somebody. So God is speaking to us through his word. Be watchful. Be alert. Because our adversary, huh? Our adversary, he's our adversary. The devil, he is walking about as a what? Roaring lion. What are you doing? Seeking who he may eat up. And he loved those ones who lack his things. You see those pictures in the jungle pictures, the pictures of the wild kingdom? When them guys can't catch them great big guys, the big prey, they look at that one sick. When they miss that big one, the little one left him behind. Oh, that baby lacking behind. Oh, that's dinner. We ain't got enough for all of us, but we get enough for some of us. So if you are wounded, if you are wounded, you better strengthen that hand. Huh? Because the devil, he's out there. He is the roaring lion. He's looking for the wounded. The wounded prey is easy. Huh? Especially when the lions get old. The animals get old, they can't run as fast as they are. They look for that easy prey. Praise somebody. So you better still look and you better start adding, huh? All right, you better start adding because he's out there. He's looking for you. Add. Watch for. You know, how many people try to strengthen the living? Praise the Lord, somebody. How you like to put a little virtue, a little power to your lifestyle? Praise the Lord. Isn't that nice? Praise the Lord. Lord, I'm short over here, so I need to put a little strength to this part. Praise the Lord. The scriptures say we have a name that we live it, but we are dead. Huh? That's false advertising. We don't supposed to be dead, do we? Huh? We are lively people. We are lively stones. Amen. Praise the Lord, somebody. Praise the Lord. Before that thing dies, before that virtue dies, that thing that is in you died, give it strength to it. Build up, as the scripture says, building up yourself on your most what? Holy faith. Praying in the Holy Spirit. Amen. Building up. Some of these guys here, man, go to the gym. They build up. Huh? You can tell them guys, you can pick out them guys among who go and exercise most of the time, especially if they pull off the shirt. you can tell them you see a guy like me walk side of him, and a guy like some of us walk side of him, and they walk, they can see us way off and know who, they know who in shape. And ain't nobody going to bother. If somebody want to pick a fight, they ain't coming to that guy like that, huh? Who going to mess with Antoine Bolden? Praise him, amen. They ain't coming to that guy with that little puny fella. That's the same with the lion. That's the same with the devil. That little puny fella that can't keep up with. That's lunch. That is lunch. That is lunch today. Praise the Lord. So. But if we get strong, praise the Lord. But when we get, I know you see pictures of Samson, and I think Samson was a little fella. I think his character, I think he was a little fella. I don't think he was such a big fella, but he was little maybe in stature. He, amen, but he was great when the power of God. Amen. The Bible said we shall receive what? Power when? After the Holy Ghost come up, we got dynamis. We got the power. Look at your neighbor and say, we got the power. God didn't give us the power. The Bible says many believe on him. To them he give power to become sons of God, to all those that believe on his name. You have the power. Jesus said, behold, I send you as sheep among wolves. And you think he sent us out powerless? No, we have the power, but we got to learn how to speak it. The devil don't want us to know what we have. Don't tell them saints, huh? Don't tell them saints. The devil knows some of the saints. The devil seen Jesus coming. The devil seen Jesus coming on the Galilean after he walked off that boat. The devil said, "I know who you are." Well, some saints don't even know. Amen. The demon said, I know who you are. Jesus said, be quiet. Shut up. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. So it's a blessing to know who we serve, to know whom we serve. Amen, somebody. Praise the Lord. When we know who we serve, we know he has given us power over all the power of the enemy. Nothing by any means shall hurt us. So we have that. God have given that to us. If we refuse to use it, it's our fault. He give it to the church. It's in the church. The church is still here. So the power of miracles, the power of healing, the power of joy, we got everything to add. We got everything to think on. And we got everything, amen, to build up ourselves upon a most holy faith. Strengthen that. Which what? That are ready to die. You know, a lot of people's, watch this one, giving. Who like to strengthen their giving? Praise the Lord, somebody. Who would like to learn how to give more? You can't beat God giving. I don't care how much you give. Praise him, somebody. I said, you can't beat God giving. I don't care how much you're giving. Because God give his son. Only son. How many people would give their own son? And how about the son giving his life? You can't go past that. That extreme. No greater love. No greater love than a man have than what? That give his what? Life. I give my life. That's all I can give. God, I'm poor in giving. Praise the Lord, somebody. Praise the Lord. I'm poor in giving, Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm so poor, I can't even tithe. I can't give a tithe. Praise the Lord, somebody. But how about putting some strength to that? Watch over. Be alert over those things, what's supposed to be in your life. What the Holy Spirit had put in your life. Guard them. Make sure they are super strong. Huh? Make sure they are super strong. That's right. When they get super strong, the scriptures speak that we can do how many things? All things. To who? Christ with what? Strengthen us. We can do what? So we can strengthen that which remains, right? Why? Because we get our energy and all our power will come from the Lord. Amen? So don't forget. Don't forget. We are here to do a good work today. Good works. Wouldn't you like to strengthen yourself to do good works? The scripture tells us to maintain good works. Praise the Lord, somebody. You know we're going to get paid off for good works? Huh? Jesus said, behold, I come quickly. My rewards is with me to pay every man according as his what? Works. His works. His works. In 1 Corinthians 3, the scripture said, amen, some men build, it said, no other foundation can be laid but that which is already laid on Christ Jesus. He tells us to be careful how we build upon this foundation. Some men build wood, hay, and stubborn. Some men build silver and gold and precious stone. All your works going to be tested by fire. This the fire. Amen. Whatsoever sort it will be, the word going to test the word. You remember what we preached on this morning? Jesus said, every plant my heavenly Father did not plant shall be what? Rooted up. That doctrine, that teaching with I didn't demand what the Pharisees got, what the Sadducees got, they got to be rooted up. Got to be plucked up. So if the Lord did not establish it, it got to be rooted up. So take heed. Take heed. Listen to the word of God. And those things you know that need and happen in your life, put some strength to them. Praise the Lord. I need more strength in the home. I need more strength in the job. Praise the Lord, somebody. Amen. You know where you need it. I don't know where you need it, but I know I need some. I need some. I got some places I like to work on. Praise the Lord, somebody. Praise the Lord. And you got some places maybe you like to work on, but the scripture tells us to be watchful. Look at it, watch it, don't let it die. Strengthen that which remaineth. My thoughts. Strengthen that which remaineth. remain in that are ready to die. Stand with me, everybody. Praise the Lord. Give the Lord a hand clap. Praise the Lord. Oh, glory to God. I need to be strengthened for this work I'm going to do today. God, empower me to be a blessing to the man and the woman of God. I need strength for this. I know the enemy done talked to me and told me how much I'm going to do, what I'm supposed to do, how much I'm supposed to give. But hey, just wait till you hear what the word. See what God says. You done made up your mind before you got here. You done got your little, you done put that little money in that side. That's all I'm going to give. Listen to God. Listen at the Spirit. Praise the Lord. Listen at the Spirit. Is that the Spirit talking? Is that the Spirit told you to do that? Or you done made up your mind in the flesh? Praise the Lord. Strengthen that which remaineth that are ready to die. Some of our giving could really need some enhancement. We need some help in it. You believe it? Huh? Praise the Lord. God can do it, can he? It is good to start exercising when you see the truth you're supposed to walk in. It is good to start it today. I can start today planting, sowing seeds in good soil. This good soil. You believe that? Put your hand over there. Say, this good soil. I'm going to plant seeds. I'm going to sow some seeds. And praise the Lord. When you sow seeds in good soil, you're going to receive a harvest. Because where you sow, you reap. And what you sow, you reap it. Praise the Lord. If there's a person in the building, you need Jesus. You'd like to be saved today. We're going to give you an altar call for being saved today. Or whatever the condition that you are in today, and you need help from the Lord. You need help from the Lord. We're just going to ask you to raise your hand where you are now. We'll pray for you right where you are. When Jesus was up on this earth, he sent forth his word, and he healed them. He delivered them. Father, those hands that are up in the auditorium today, I can speak. I can say. I can say. I can speak to their situation. I can speak to their problems, oh God, and you will dissolve them because I am doing what you told me to do. Whatever their needs is, Lord, those hands that is up in the air, meet those needs in Jesus' name to the glory of God. I call it done in Jesus' name. Say it's done. God bless you. Praise him. All right. Maybe see. All right. Deacon Elton, come on. And come on, Boynton. Let's be a blessing. Praise the Lord. God put on your heart what God put on your heart, what God put on your heart today. Let's be a blessing. Man, when you know. When you know where you're planting seeds, when you know where you're sowing at, huh? Sometimes you go and plant seeds and saw and you ain't never seen the person before. Or you saw him on TV, or you ain't never seen him before. He's come to your church one time with a red bandana around his neck. You know, y'all don't see much of that in y'all days when I was coming up, I'm joking with that red bandana. I come from California. They like to tell you come way out of town somewhere. You know, that's for the influence to scare them Florida people. Praise the Lord. They come down to Florida and wipe us out because they come from California. Praise the Lord. Okay. All right. So we're going to pass on and see what.
Come on, clap your hands, everybody. Let's declare to the body of Christ that we're walking in the favor of God. Listen. I'm walking in the favor of God. His grace and mercy has brought me this far. I will believe all his words. brought me this far. I will believe all his word says about me. Lack and poverty is not my destiny, 'cause I'm walking and I'm living. I'm walking in the favor of God. Come on, sing in the favor of God. His grace and mercy has brought me in the favor of God. His grace and mercy has brought me this far. I will believe all his word says about me. Lack and poverty is not my destiny, 'cause I'm walking and I'm in the favor of God. His grace and mercy in the favor of God. His grace and mercy has brought me this far. I will believe all his word says about me. Lack and poverty is not my destiny, 'cause I'm walking and I'm living. I'm walking in the favor of God. Come on, sing.
I'm walking,
and I'm living,
I'm living,
I'm brought me this far. I will believe all his word says about me. Lack and poverty is not my destiny. Brought me this far. I will be
Bishop. Clap the hand for the bishop, please. Word of God. All right. I want to say thank you very kindly. I'm going to let Sister Banks say thanks. And then I got to say something because y'all just blessed me today. I'm going to say that.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. I do give God honor for his presence being in the midst of us. Amen.
Amen.
To our chief overseer and our mother, Fanny, yes. Our national mother, all the ministers, men of God, women of God, we thank and praise God for you coming out here today, right? Amen. I'm going to say this. I'm going to give it over to him. It has already been said, but I really enjoyed that women's convention. Yeah. I really did.
Yeah.
Amen. Thank God for the That's national good. Mother and the sister national mother. They call on us and have us to do things. They want our input. We give our input. Amen. Amen. And I do thank God for that. I really appreciated that morning session. It was very nice. And all the sisters that come out, we know some have to work, but I just enjoyed the women's convention. I really did. And thank God for you all, and I love you. God bless you.
God bless you. Thank God for you. Just you don't know how much you blessed my heart today just to see you follow our leader. That blessed me right there. Y'all bless me. Y'all ain't had to do nothing. When I saw that, y'all could have came in benediction, went on. But you know you got to come and give because that's the only way you can be blessed. Okay, all right. But it really do bless my heart to see us catching a hold to what God has said to us. Amen. I tell my church this. We came out of the First Fruit Revival. I told them, I said, y'all got to be out of y'all mind. Y'all think I'm going to be the same man. I refuse to be the same man. We refuse to do things the same way. Amen. And I thank God for you just really encouraged my heart. Now everybody gonna catch a hold to it, but I see you. You got a hold to the thing. And I thank God for you all coming down and support us. And as your the district overseer, I really do. I got a heart to just try to strengthen the church and to do all I can for the body of Christ. And make sure I get up under my leader and hold him up and see the hand of God be upon us. The Lord kind of dealt with me in a message now that I'm doing now, Bishop. And he spoke to my heart. He told me, and you know, the only thing that has been that has been keeping us back from the increase that God wants us to have, let me tell you something. Stop listening at the naysayers. Stop listening to them people that don't believe that God wants supernatural abundance over your life. The thing, you know, God kind of spoke to my heart. He said, now the thing that's been holding back the supernatural abundance that God has for us is preparation. Preparation. When the people of God get prepared, then we're going to see the supernatural abundance, the blessing of the Lord fall in our lives. Because the abundance cannot fall on unprepared people. We have to get prepared. And you got to believe what the word says about you and not what everybody else thinking and what everybody else saying. The Bible says, if I give sparingly, I'm going to reap sparingly. Is that what it says? I don't know what knucklehead going in the scripture messing that up. If I give bountifully, I'm going to reap. How you mess that up? How you going to say then God don't want to bless us because we give? And I can't understand even how the saints of God would listen at something like that. So God is saying to us, and I'm going to do a message on this coming Sunday, and I believe God is trying to prepare us for the abundance that he have on us. Because we can't handle the abundance if we're not prepared. You got to stop thinking. I was sitting down at the table, and I said, and I'm done. The word of God. The bishop said it today. We got to add to our faith. Add to what God done blessed us with. And I was sitting down at that table. And, you know, and this such became such a revelation to me. I said, and we was talking. I was talking to Deacon Red and Minister Bob. We were sitting down talking. And we was talking about the message. And what was said was, the reason why a lot of people don't experience harvest because they did not sow in the time of sowing season. It's a season of sowing. Stop expecting a harvest if you don't sow in the sowing season. Amen. And it jumped in my spirit. I said, wow, man. You know, everybody looking for the harvest, but they forget about the season to sow. That's when, and it was Deacon Red that spoke to him. He said God spoke to him in the midst of it. And he said God spoke to him. And he says every month he going to give his whole check one time a month to the ministry. He said because he believed that right now in his life it's a season of sowing. We got to get this stuff. If I believe, let me tell you something. I believe that every one of us in here should operate in abundance. I don't believe abundance is just for a few of us. You know, you look at the bishop and you look at, you know, different people, you know, and say, well, you know, that's abundance. I believe God has abundance. I'm not saying everybody going to be millionaires. I'm saying God want to bless everybody with more than enough. Because it's in his word. And don't you be sitting around no naysayers that be talking all that crazy talk. You're talking about the reason why we haven't received it because we haven't prepared ourselves. And we come and give an offering, and sometimes we give money, and you know, when we're feeling good. But think about that's what Bishop said, strengthen that thing. If I missed in my tithe, then I'm finna tighten it up. Tithe don't belong to you, it belongs to God. So if I have been tithing properly, I'm finna get myself prepared. Amen. Now, you got to get yourself prepared if you're going to handle the abundance God want to place on your life. Don't talk about you're going to handle $50,000 when you can't handle two. Stop talking about God going to bless you with millions. You don't know how to handle 1,000. Amen. Learn how to handle finances. Then get yourself prepared for it. Get prepared for the abundance that God done promised to bless us with. Say amen. Y'all don't believe that? Man, I believe that like crazy. Amen. Thank God for you. And just, again, you really did bless my heart. I looked at it. I said, man, boy. I said, look at Mother Church. Boy, they trying to come show us up. You blessed the heart of the district overseer. Thank God for you. And I know we appreciate you all. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you again, Bishop, Mother Fanny. Thank you, preachers, ministers. Thank you, Mother. God bless you. Thank you. We love y'all. God bless you. And Nick, man, you bless me, man. Hey, what can I say, man? Now, I saw that boy there on the drum. I said, that boy blessing me today. You better follow Bishop, boy. That's right. That's what you're supposed to do. Stay in your place, rightful place. You be there. I saw DJ Red in the choir singing.
Watch
out. That's what I'm talking about. He ain't say he ain't bring, had to bring no equipment down here, but he down there quite singing, following his bishop. I like that. You tell me a man can't get blessed, a woman can't get blessed if they do that. Can you shout amen? God bless you. Thank y'all for coming. I'm done. Rest on your feet. We're going to let you go home. Yes. Amen. Get us a night, let us know. Get us a night, let us know. We'll be there with bells on. Amen. Yeah, that's right. Amen. I believe that abundance coming our way, so we got to sow these seeds. Amen. God bless you. Thank God for you. All right. And God bless you, Bishop. Now, Deacon James, you, huh? Bishop said that we're going to get a night so we can bless Elder Jackson and Sister Jackson, retired pastor. We're going to get a night so we can bless them. Yes, we're going to do it over. Yes. All right, thank God for you. Thank God for you, and we're loving on you in Jesus' name. You want to do the benediction? Lift your hands towards heaven. Now unto him that is able to keep you.